This is going to be interesting because I just realized right now I do have no notes for my lecture. But that's all right. We can keep going this, and we're all friends here, right? So I run a project called Guerrilla Skepticism on Wikipedia, and I will be referring to it as the GSoW project. So how many people here marched for science? Excellent. I see two hands up by Claire over there. And you probably watched it on TV or on the YouTube or on Facebook Live or Twitter or whatever. It was a really exciting time. I'm from California, or America, if you guys haven't already figured that out. And in America, we have this president. I apologize. Imagine how we feel. So the March for Science was started because people were, a little upset, a little concerned about what was happening with the anti-science rhetoric that was coming out of our government. It was really, really sad. So we put on a March for Science. And this is a photo that I took at Monterey County Skeptics, which is the organization I run locally. It's my local, and you're all welcome to come and hang out with us anytime you want. But this is a photo I took at our March for Science, and I absolutely love this. I am a photographer, and I think it sums up the entire March for Science in one photograph. As you can see, this little guy over here with his pink hat and his socks that are ones up, ones down, and he's so excited. He's marching for science. It's so cool. And then look at the woodpeckers. Aren't they great? Anybody else dressed up as a woodpecker? This poor guy isn't so happy. I feel bad for him. I think he wanted to be a penguin or something, yeah. So let's see what slides next. So I am running this organization, and we're trying to improve Wikipedia pages. We're trying to really combat what we find on Wikipedia to really make sure that we're putting our best foot forward, because we need to absolutely own this. Wikipedia is a skeptic's dream. We're asking for citations, we're asking for evidence, and the evidence, the quality of evidence that we're putting up there has to be great evidence. Oops, so these are slides that weren't supposed to be here. So, let's find out. So, how many people have heard of the Burzynski Clinic? Awesome. I want Bob Blaskowitz to realize that a lot of people here put up their hand. So, Bob Blaskowitz and David Gorski and other people with science-based medicine, they put out this, they've been really trying to attack this clinic in Houston, Texas, that wasn't flooded in the last rain. You don't need to know much about the Burzynski Clinic other than knowing that it is a cancer quack clinic. He is trying to treat, he says he's treating people's cancer. And, well, you know. So people are going to go to Wikipedia. They're going to Google the Burzynski Clinic, or they're going to try to find out information whenever they're trying to find out where do they go when their child is desperate and they have a dying child or they're dying themselves from stage 4 cancer. And they're going to Google it, and one of the first hits they're going to get is? Yeah, Wikipedia. So they went to Wikipedia, and they're going to find this Burzynski Wikipedia page. And it's got all sorts of amazing information on it. You don't have to read it right now. But it has explains who he is, it explains how it was founded, it explains his record, it explains that there are anti-Burzynski sites and so on the page. Now, the GSoW project did not write this page. We have just kind of maintained it. This is something that is was already there. We just kind of helped it out. And I do want to point out that the GSoW editing team is not the only editors on Wikipedia. Wikipedia is run by an amazing group of volunteers all over the world, and they are skeptics even if they don't identify as a skeptic, because they require evidence, they require facts, they require great evidence. It can't just be a site like a blog or something. It has to be a really good site that they put up. If not for the majority of people on Wikipedia, the editors who are there, Wikipedia would turn into the conservapedia within a very short amount of time. So my team, this is international. I have people all over the world, which is why I'm on tour with Mark Edward and Pontus and who are you over there? We are on tour to try to get editors. So I'm here to recruit you. Just saying. Because the Burzynski Clinic recruits people and brings people in from all over the world, we felt that it was very important that we have Wikipedia pages written in languages that the people in other countries who are also desperate from cancer, stage 4 cancer, because cancer doesn't know languages or cultures. We had to write the Wikipedia page in many different languages. And my notes are not here, so this is a Wikipedia page I believe we wrote in Dutch. Thank you very much. So this is a Wikipedia page that's been translated into Dutch. And this is a Wikipedia page that we have translated into Polish. No, this isn't Polish. What is it?
Spanish.
Oh, thank you, Valkyria. I should know that. It's the only other language I can't speak, but this is an interactive lecture. That's great. So we translated into Spanish, and then we had to translate it into Italian because of this gentleman. How many people know who he is? Fabio. Fabio is a huge supporter of the Burzynski Clinic. His sister is dying of stage 4 cancer, and he brought her to the Burzynski Clinic. She died a few weeks later, not because of the clinic, but because she was very, very ill. So Fabio, we didn't know if Fabio is going to go on tour in Italy. We don't know. We just need to be ready so that when he does decide that he's going to speak about Burzynski as a supporter, that he's able to, people in Italy will get their information in Italian without having to rely on Google Translate or somebody else explaining it to them. So we also translated it into
Italian,
there you go, there's the Italian page, thank you. And then we also translated it into
Polish.
And why do we have to do this in Polish? Because he's Polish. Thank you. So in Poland, apparently, he's kind of a name. The other Wikipedia pages I showed you, okay, the English page receives about 300 page views a day. It receives, you know, maybe hundreds of 100,000 page views every couple of years. It receives a lot of page views in English because he's living in America. The other pages, since we've created them, they've received maybe 4,000 or 5,000 page views, 6,000 page views. We're ready, waiting for whenever he does. He speaks out in another language, or a supporter speaks out for. But in Polish, this Wikipedia page, since we created it, is already at 30,000 page views. These are not skeptics reading this page. 30,975 to be exact. I do have some notes because I had to get my numbers right before I came out because the numbers change every day. So this receives normally about 20 page views a day. In 2 days in October, it received 1,000 page views. I don't know why, but something happened in the media and he was getting attention. So this is one of my favorites. Grief Vampire. Tyler Henry. It is not important for you to know who Tyler Henry is. He is just the new flavor of the day, a fuzzy sweater psychics that Mark Edward is always referring to as the new generation of psychics. We're long gone with the psychics who used to speak like Lilia Brown, I'm sure it's so rude to be a mom. Now we have the fuzzy sweater psychics. These are the people who look like they would bag your groceries. They're the type who look like you could leave your dog with and they would house sit for you. They're the nice people next door that they're so nice that there's no way they could be lying to you. These are sweet people. So Tyler Henry, as I said, you don't need to know who he is. He's, like I say, he's just the new guy on the block. He's 20 years old or 21 now. In 2016, he got a show on a network in America called E!, which is Entertainment Network. He is brand new to the game. So new that there's no criticism on him. So I was made aware of this man, and I decided, yeah, I can research and I can write. So I was able to write some articles about Tyler Henry, and I was going through his readings, and I was able to see what he has written and write critical articles that are not slamming him or anything like that, but they're just talking about what he's saying and so on. And I post them up on Skeptical Inquirer magazine. Now, because Skeptical Inquirer magazine is notable, which means it has its own Wikipedia page, then it is available to put on a Wikipedia page. That's how it works, notability works. So Tyler Henry, and here he is with one of my favorite people, I'm sure yours as well, he got a lot of publicity because nobody had ever heard of him. He just sprang on the scene. He was actually someone that they picked up from like a psychic shop in California and put him out there. And he does readings for celebrities. So he has been supported a lot by Dr. Phil. And he is a grief vampire. He is the type of Mark Edward has coined the term also for grief vampire, that these are these people who are not the people who have the little shops or do the tarot reading. These are people who are actually claiming to speak to your dead people. These are the despicable and harmful people we call grief vampires, because they're trying to leech onto you and get your and claim to speak to your dead person. So Tyler Henry, here's where it gets fun. I don't need notes for this. These are stats. Now, I need to mention to you that page view stats are only tell us that somebody has accessed the Wikipedia page. It does not tell us if it's a unique viewer, because it could be somebody clicking on the page over and over. It does not tell us if they clicked on and clicked off immediately. It doesn't tell us how long they spent on the Wikipedia page. It only tells us that they access the page. That's all we have to be able to tell how effective it is that what we're doing works. These are Tyler Henry's stats. These are from the time the page was created, and I should mention that my project did not create this page, somebody else did, using some of the articles that I had written and published on Skeptical Inquirer. And this goes from the beginning of February of 2016 all the way to May 2017. I don't know how well you guys can see this, but these are the stat page views. And look at how these huge numbers are. This is 14,000 page views in one day, and so on. And then a low of about 1,800, 1,500 page views a day. Another spike, a lull, and then a couple more spikes. Anybody want to take a guess what the spikes are from? Dr. Phil, yeah, from media coverage. So these are spikes. Now these are huge amounts. Now at the time I wrote this page, I made this screenshot, he had 850,000 page views. That's a lot of page views. I'd like to have 800,000 page views, right? But if this man could speak to the dead, think about it. This man would not have 800,000 page views over a year and a half time. He'd have 800,000 page views a day, maybe every hour. You gotta think about this, people. They can't speak to the dead. That would be, as Mark says, very dangerous. They'd be the most dangerous person in the world. So I should mention, there is a Susan Gerbic Wikipedia page. I receive almost no page views for anything that I do because I'm not in the media. I only speak to skeptics, more or less. So my page views are just kind of like maybe 20 page views a day, no big deal. But as the most prominent critic of Tyler Henry, when I write about Tyler Henry, and on my Facebook page, I just put up a new article that just came out about Tyler Henry and how he maybe killed somebody. So check my Facebook page. It just came out while we were at the conference. That should make you want to go, right? We'll go after in a minute. Go during lunch. So because I have a Wikipedia page, I also am mentioned on Tyler Henry's Wikipedia page. I hope you're following this okay. So you can see, here's the same dates. These are some stats, kind of low. I mean, they're high for a skeptic that has no notability outside of this, but there's a lull, there's a spike, there's a lull, and there's some spikes. Now these are in the hundreds, not in the thousands like Tyler's. I'm gonna put these two together. So you can see, what is going on here, very clearly, is this little dips and everything are exactly matching Tyler Henry's. That's because people are going to the Tyler Henry Wikipedia page to find out who the heck this guy is that's on TV. And then they're seeing the chief critic and they're going to that page too. So we know that having criticism on a Wikipedia page is getting access. It's not getting access in the way we would like. I mean, this many, like I say, this is a logarithmic chart. So these are thousands of page views up here in blue, and these are hundreds of page views here in the green. So it's not a huge difference. But anybody notice anything odd about the Susan Gerbic stats? You already know on the brush. Anybody else notice anything? Yeah, there's some holes there. What the heck? Right here, that does not correspond with the Tyler Henry, and right here, that does not correspond with the Tyler Henry. Why is that? All the criticism was removed from the Tyler Henry page, exactly. And once it was noticed, it was added back in, which kind of acts as a control, because we can see that this is happening, and how if there's no criticism on the Wikipedia page, he's not getting any criticism. So, here we go. Let's see what's next. This is a fun game. So I'm going to mention very quickly that we had the Olympics not so long ago. You guys remember the U.S. swim team coming out with their big sucker marks on them, the kikis all over them, all over their bodies? Well, not only did we all notice that, but guess what? The media noticed it. They're looking for that human interest. As Ron just mentioned, the media is underfunded, they're overworked, and we have to have things ready for them so that they can just kind of run with it. So what happened is the cupping therapy, that's what those hickey marks were. This is called a lead of a Wikipedia page, and most people only read the lead and then they're off the page and off to a cat video or something, I don't know. So before the GSoW before the GSOW realized what was going on, because we're not psychic, we turned on our Facebook feed also, and we said, oh my gosh, what the heck is going on here? Us and the media were going crazy about, what is this cupping therapy? I ran over to the Wikipedia page, well, we didn't run, but I went to the Wikipedia page for cupping therapy to see what the world was seeing. And you know what they were seeing? If you summed up the article in the lead, they were seeing it said, cupping is old and it works. That's what it said. Can you imagine that? So what happened is I and my other Wikipedia editors, as well as the rest of the Wikipedia world, ran over like crazy and went and changed the page. So now if you were to sum up the Wikipedia page, it says it's old, it does not work, and it may harm you. So that's what happened. So this is what happened to the page views, because the world is trying to figure out, what is this cupping stuff? What the heck is that? And you can see it receives about 1,800 page views a day. Every time a celebrity goes onto Instagram with the little hickey marks on the back, somebody's going, what the heck is that? But look, cupping therapy got 106,000 page views in one day. And then as we go down here, they still received, you know, hundreds of thousands, you know, thousands of page views a day. So this week or so that the Olympics was going on and the U.S. swim team is prancing around with their pseudoscience placebo hickeys, they, coined that term, somebody, that's good. They received probably about 500,000 page views to a Wikipedia page that we got in shape pretty darn quick, and it said, this does not work. What was happening, let me see if I can do this quickly, is the media didn't know what to do. So they called in cupping experts to show how it works, and put the people laying down on the reporters and got the cupping and stuff, and how does it feel? Hey Joe, how does it feel? It's okay. You know, I mean, so we went and put notable people we had written Wikipedia pages for. We wrote these Wikipedia pages and others, and they're experts in the medical field, and they had written about cupping, so we went and put their names on the Wikipedia pages, critics, so that the media would be able to contact somebody who is sane, who has, you know, credentials, and so on. And these are just some of the people that we mentioned. There's Edward Ernst, Harriet Hall, Simon Singh, and Mark Prispitt. And I just wanted to point out that for the little time that they were mentioned in the lead, which wasn't long, they also have a spike. Now this isn't 106,000 page views, these are hundreds or so. But it still shows that if you can get information on a Wikipedia page, somebody's looking at it, and hopefully it's the media, and they're gonna contact our people and say, hey, I see that you have also written about this, you look sane, you're articulate, because we've also made sure that the Wikipedia page shows that they have been writing, doing other writings or have done publications or TV appearances and so on. So the media is more likely to contact the people we put on these Wikipedia pages. Well, my slides, these are reversed. I was supposed to start with this person, but that's okay. Anybody know who Stanley Plotkin is? He may have saved the life of somebody in this room. Stanley Plotkin, we just wrote this Wikipedia page in August, and this is how it appears when I made this screenshot a few days ago. One of my problems with this, the world as it is that we're too focused on the wrong people, I think. You know, we know what Kim Kardashian's wearing today. We know what sports heroes are doing. But do we really know who our real heroes are? The people who really are the people we should be represented? I don't think we do. The scientists, the people who save our lives, the people who do the research, the people who speak out, the bloggers who are being killed in countries for speaking out about something as about a God belief. I don't think we've got their backs. I really don't think we do, because we don't know these people. And I'm not saying there's anything wrong, because I didn't know this man's name or anything he had done either. But this is just one example of hundreds, if not thousands, of pages that are waiting to be done. Stanley Plotkin, he's in his late 70s now. He was instrumental on writing and discovering vaccines for German measles, rubella, for a pneumonia vaccine, the MMR. He also was instrumental in rabies. He could have saved lives. He may have saved thousands of lives across the world, yet we do not know who he is. This is the Wikipedia page now, and these are the citations at the bottom. There are 23 citations now for this man. Prepare yourself. This is what the world saw for years, because he was forgotten. I call this a non-scroller, because you don't need to scroll to see the entire page. That is it. Five citations to represent this man who we should revere as a hero, amongst a lot of other people in our community. And I don't want to end on a negative note, so I'm going to end on a positive note. This is what Wikipedia, this is what my project does, the GSoW project. Not only does it try to get information on Wikipedia pages that are pseudoscientific, to make sure that the media has some great place to find information, to put the best foot forward for our community, our history, our people, our scientists, our activists. But we also want to make sure that these people are not forgotten. We wrote to Stanley Plotkin, and he said, I'm flattered you undertook this, especially as I approached the end of my career and asked myself whether or not I have accomplished anything. I get emotional every time I read that. And I've given this lecture a few times. Can you imagine that? Let that sink in. He was forgotten and he felt forgotten. And it's our fault. Because nobody owns Wikipedia if we don't have it. And we need to have this. Completely rewrite, not of just everything we've done. I have 5 minutes, perfect. Okay. We can't keep track of everything we do, that's insane. So as of this morning, gosh, My Wikipedia page has just added a couple more pages. We're 467 pages we've written, or completely rewritten, like Stanley's Plotkin's page, in many languages. We have been working on Wikipedia pages for the ESCO, the European Skeptic Congress. We've been working on that for a long time. Leon, where are you? Stand up. Sorry, I'm embarrassed. I don't think I can embarrass Leon. Everybody, Leon has been instrumental to making sure that the European Skeptics Congress pages, and other people are contributing as well, but it's represented, I'm going to represent them through Leon. The European Skeptic Organization page didn't really exist until Leon got there, and he's had it translated into many other languages. And this morning, I woke up to see that it's been translated into Portuguese. I feel that the ESCO is like the United Nations. It should be translated into every language that represents it, and that's silly to be forgotten and not to have been done for so many years until we're actually pushing it to be done. It was translated into Czech, just like recently as well. And in the last couple days, the Czech Skeptics page for the organization was just translated into English and into Polish. We have kept track of all things associated with ESCO, I mean the board members, the different representations, and so on. And as I said, this is led by Leon. He's absolutely prolific. Anything related to ESCO has just hit 142,060 page views. Okay, and in preparation, stay standing, Leon, don't worry. I have need for you. In preparation for this conference, my editors have been working frantically to make sure that the pages of the speakers were written and everybody's page was in order. Not everybody got done, but we got as far as we could possibly do. Adam, where are you? There he is. It's embarrassing, but I'm doing it. So Adam is my only Polish editor. Just saying. He started in January. I believe you finished training in January or February, just very recently. So Adam has been translating pages and writing some of the Wikipedia pages for almost everybody here who's a speaker into Polish. He has written 28 pages since he's been with me in the last 8 months, something like that. And those 28 pages have already reached 39,787 page views. Now, that's amazing. And that's in Polish. I have some people I don't have any language for. All right, lastly, and I will close on this. My last thing is, I've got 2.5 minutes. Every one of my editors stand up. Trained or untrained. I see you, get up. I have a huge group of editors, Andras up here in Hungary. And Clara in the back, who's been standing all this time, is now still standing because she was one of my editors also. So I just want you guys to look around, and I want you guys to see that this is, I'm on stage, yes, but I am so proud of my people. I want you to understand how important these people are to our community, to our group. I have 95 or 97 or 98, gosh, I can't even keep track because it keeps changing. We've had editors join the last few days. But I want you to know that as of this morning, we keep track of these numbers, of these pages, only the pages that we have completely rewritten or pages rewritten, not just the normal edits we do. In the last 7 days, those 467 pages have hit 122,360 page views in a week. In a month, we've had, and I like having every single number, 695,196 page views, that's a month. And in total, we have had 14,161,317 page views in total. There's nobody in the skeptic community that has an organization that's able to get affect people outside the choir, not just skeptics like we are. So we'd love to have your support. I just want to say, let's not let people like Stanley Plotkin and the thousands you can see and the thousands of other editors and the Wikipedia pages out there that are waiting to be improved because we don't want them to be forgotten. And as, heck, 22 seconds, and as Leo Igwe said, come on now, come on now, come on now. We have got to be able to do this. And I appreciate your time. Thank you.